give you the world, baby girl. You just gotta be worth it. You don't gotta be perfect. You just gotta be worth it. Yeah.
What's up, A&L fam? We are back with another vlog. It's your girl, Leah.
And it's your girl, Lena. Y'all already knows who it is. Rocking at 704, living in a 336.
Okay, y'all. That kind of caught me off guard, so my bad. But, y'all, we ain't really been on here for a minute. That's our apologies. We apologize. But before we get into anything, everything, I want y'all to stop what you're doing right now. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that notification bell so you can get notified every time we upload a video. And then go to the comments and show us love, because why?
Because we always show double the love back. Y'all already knows how we do.
And if you're new to the family, which there's some that's new, welcome. Hey, how are you? Welcome to the A&L fam. They are a what now?
Y'all are now considered a cousin. Welcome to the family.
So on this day, you want to tell them what we're doing or where we're going today, babe?
We are going to the Bullhole.
Yes.
Anybody in Coolamy or near Statesville, Salisbury, y'all know what the Bullhole is. It's the lake. Got a pretty ass waterfall. Yeah, we taking y'all with us so y'all see when we get there. Just some relaxation. I went there yesterday, cleared my mind. We had a lot going on. It's been a lot.
It's been a lot these past couple of
weeks,
I guess you will say. Oh, this is just a turn of lane. You gotta get over.
Okay.
So yeah, you might wanna hurry. But yeah, this past couple of weeks, we've had like some changes, some things happen. Good.
Wait.
Oh,
no, Jesus. This is it. What was I supposed to go that way?
You're supposed to go that way.
Damn it.
Y'all, hold on. Y'all done tilted and everything. No, I think you're going the right way.
Sure.
Yes. Sorry, y'all. Yeah, you're going the right way. And even if not, it'll reroute us. But yeah, you're going the right way. Okay. Back on track, y'all. We're trying to she went there yesterday, like she said, but we've had a lot going on. You want to get in detail with it, babe?
Let's start with the apartment that we got. So
yes,
we are moving, y'all.
I know we took y'all to go look at houses, so let's get it, because y'all probably like, wait, they had house. We had houses. Our intentions was to get a house, right? That's our intentions, because we want more room. We're about to actually, we're getting everything in order. We got our steps to buy a home when it's time, because we don't want to be, you know, point blank that you see it. But with everything going on, the house was just out of our cards right now. And yeah, right now,
like, for one, our lease was too fucking long.
Yes.
Like, we was expecting our lease to be up a few months ago, as y'all remember.
Yeah.
But come to find out, our lease is not up till August 1st.
And every house that we found, it's like they wouldn't hold it. They wouldn't. Then it's gone. And then literally right now, there's no house on the market that we see. There's no house.
Yeah, because everybody is grabbing them.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
So we were looking for three and two. Three bedroom, two bath. So let's get to that too. Right now we're at a three bedroom, two bath apartment. It's beautiful. Everybody loves how our apartment looks. So I'm going to tell y'all, the apartment we're going to is beautiful. We'll do a, we can do a tour for that too.
Yeah.
Don't mind y'all, it's beautiful. And it's got bigger square footage than where we're at now, which is crazy, but it does. But y'all, we had to downsize a little bit. It's a 2-2. We have a two bedroom, two bath. But see, that's what we have to do because we couldn't find no three and two, right, babe?
Yeah.
But
they had threes, I think, but they ain't had none.
Then none's available right now. They wouldn't be available.
August.
They wouldn't be available till way later. Yeah, August 5th or August later. And like we said, our lease is up. So what will we be doing?
And August was a weird month to move. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but it was just, it felt so weird because when we looked, there was nothing available. Nothing was going to be available in fucking August.
No.
Or, you know, at the end of July. We barely caught this
one. Barely. And because
we almost having to stay where we at. We've been there for 3 years. We was almost having to stay there again.
Y'all probably moving. I'm
probably
sorry.
Another few months. But luckily this came through. So we're happy about that.
Yeah, we got it. We wasn't sure because it's very beautiful. The community's beautiful. It's a gated-in community area.
Yeah.
We're gonna be on the second floor, but it's nice. It comes with a sunroom. Like I said, we're gonna give y'all the tour of. I'm not sure if it's gonna be an empty tour or with it furnished, because how we're gonna be moving, getting our keys, the gate keys and all that. Okay, so there's that that's been going on. We had to wait on that, go see that, just getting a place. But when we found out we had it, it's good.
And part two of why we ended up choosing apartment, not only was the houses getting gone so quickly, my job we can't get any more overtime. They not allowing no overtime. I don't know if it's just due to the COVID, because we work haven't picked completely back up, or if they're gonna try to continue on with this no overtime. I live for the freaking overtime.
So she did
that hurt my pockets, and I didn't want to struggle, because the houses that we were finding, you know, were a lot more expensive. Mm-hmm. So I told her, you know, and she didn't want to get another job right now with the whole COVID going on, because I work two jobs. Anybody that know me know I work two or three jobs.
And then I just remember her saying, babe, we might have to hold off on the house, and I'm sorry, because I know we was wanting it. She was like, we might have to get another apartment. And I was just like, okay.
And don't get me wrong, what we're moving to is more expensive than what we at now.
Yes.
But it's cheaper than the houses we were looking at.
Mm-hmm.
So that bummed me a lot. I was frustrated about work.
Yeah.
We can only get 40 hours. We can go a little over 40, but I'm used to kicking close to 60 hours a week there. And, you know, that was good money for me. So now I'm just like, okay, it's nothing like that extra money. That extra money is everything.
Yo, I'm sorry if it's moving around. This highway is a little, I'm trying to hold it, but... And it says bump everywhere, so I apologize. Okay, so that's one of the things is about the apartment. What's the second thing that you would like to talk about?
The second thing is we had a big falling out.
Yes.
Stressful. We haven't been doing too well. Now, all of this shit going on in 1 week.
In 1 week,
no,
y'all.
2 weeks.
It's like, yeah, 2 weeks.
2 weeks stretched. So it was stress on top of stress.
Yeah.
And then her thyroids have been all out of whack, which has caused the tension, a lot of the tension between us.
Yeah. So I remember my doctor saying, it's going to take a while. So I started Googling. I told her, I said, I need to know this thyroid handing out. I need to know the medicine I'm taking, what it does. My mom told me it took her a while for them to get her medicine right. I've had people at my other job, obviously at RHA, that would tell me they've had it. They're like, Aaliyah, it's a process, you know, you got to be patient, you got to, and I'm like, I'm going to fight this, I'll be good, I'm young, I'm okay. It really don't matter if you're young, it don't matter if you're older, it don't matter if you feel like you're the strongest person. You can only fight so much before it really hits you and you feel, and it's raining.
Son of a gun.
Hopefully it don't rain when we get there. How?
Damn.
Y'all, it's raining.
Damn, baby.
It's raining.
Yeah,
hopefully it ain't raining when we get there. Okay, so, I don't want to ramble all about the thyroid, y'all, and y'all be like, okay, but it is a process. The thyroid is a serious thing for a woman. Our hormones are based off of the thyroids, and when people get a hysterectomy as being older, it affects a woman's hormones. And my levels got so bad. I mean, in the hundreds. It was awful. The worst my doctor says she's seen. This is how bad it was. Excuse me. When I first had my medicine, I had to take for 3 days straight two of them to make it 300 milligrams. That's how bad my stuff was. And then I'm still trying. The medicine is still getting there. But some days I just feel blah. Some days I'm so irritable. Some days I get aggravated. I can still tell I ain't been feeling myself, because there's some things that I feel just happy. I don't laugh as I used to be or be as I used to be. And the worst part, y'all, is I take everything out on my babe. Donna.
Vice versa.
I feel like my moods and my things has been different right now than ever before, because I can normally bounce back. I normally be okay. And it's like I can't sleep at night. And it's just like when she asks how do I feel or why something, my answer is I don't know. And that's all I can give, because I don't know. Like, I don't have an answer. I don't know. It's a lot. And it's like I be telling her, I just can't wait till I'm good to where I can stop just being that way. There's sometimes, like, I'm not the type of person, I'll call my mom every day, right? I'll call, talk to you. There's sometimes I don't even want to be on the phone. I don't even want to do nothing. It's just enough for me to get up out of bed, to go to work, to come home, and just stay in bed. Like, I just can't wait. And I don't know if it's I need another medicine. Do I need something different? But I called my doctor, and she was like, well, you have to wait. It takes a while for it to get in your system. That's why you have an appointment on the 6th, August 6th, mind y'all. So that's a while away. But I'm trying. I'm going to have to try to figure it out. And I told Bae, you know, like she said, well, maybe you might need to have time by yourself, just get away or just do something. I said, maybe I do need to do that. Try something to figure something out to work, because it's a lot. I just can't wait until everything is good.
Hoping that we can make it to the Bullhole
and just, not be breaking.
You know, leave our troubles at the lake.
Yeah.
Just get up some fresh air, new scenery. That might, you know, help us get back on track. But we still together. We still, you know, chopping shit.
She's
just ran through another rough patch, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna be many more. But
I say it's
all about how we able
overcome
it,
exactly,
and how we also able to fix it. Because if it's gonna keep happening, and we struggle to fix it, it's in vain. We're doing all of this in vain. Mm-hmm. So hopefully, we can, you know, talk about, communicate ways to fix it so it don't happen again, or as much, or we don't keep repeating the same problems.
Exactly. You gotta get off this exit up here, and I don't see a way for you. And she's right, and I feel like this, like, every couple has rough patches, and this is for anybody in the world. Single, couple, doesn't matter. This is something that's true, and I know everybody will back me up. When you have something good going in your life, or you just got the best news, like she said, we got that apartment, you did everything. The devil always finds a way to try to come in to break it up, right?
Yeah, always. Sometimes it's not the devil, sometimes it's us, man.
I mean, it is us, but as us being it, it's the devil inside or doing something. That's what that is. That's where you got to overcome, and you can't let that negative, the bad, the ugly, this exit. Yeah. That's where you got to have good spirits and just, you know, you got to do that and try to work at it, or even beat it something. You can't let the bad overcome when good. And that's how it always happens. When you have good, that negative, I say it's the devil, but it could be the negative devil, some overcoming.
Yeah.
That's how I feel. You're going to turn left. But y'all, you want to say anything else, babe?
Just want to know how y'all been.
Yeah, we've been running out. You haven't even asked normally.
We had to get all of that off our chest for y'all. How y'all been? How y'all been, cousins, family? We hope good. We hope good. We hope y'all have enjoyed the last 2 weekends, because y'all, as y'all remember from the previous videos, we told y'all we would only be vlogging and uploading videos or content on the weekends.
We're going to talk to y'all when we get there. We're still driving. We're almost there. We're going to stop and grab us lunch.
Sorry, right, y'all. We're in Subway getting us some lunch.
What's that say? You're a jerk. Babe.
Alright, y'all. So, we're leaving out of Subway.
Yep.
Got us some lunch.
Got us some tuna wraps. Oh, they look so good.
Hell yeah.
Well, mine looks good because she got the tomato basil. Don't give me a look awful. I don't look good.
Look at my hair. Comb head ass muscle. God damn. All right, it done stop raining. Feel good out here now. It's hot.
Good.
Hot as fuck. We only like 5 minutes from the lake.
It's hot as hell. About to burn up, but yeah. And now we already decide what we're gonna do next weekend too, y'all.
Yep.
Oh, my bad. Don't want to get copyrighted. I think her hair looks good back here. She's like, yeah, right. Like, she does need to wash it and twist it.
I need to go to the barbershop.
It does smell a little funky, but I mean.
But I was too emotional yesterday to go.
You was too what? Do your hand again.
Too emotional. I was an emotional wreck.
Yeah, you
I was trying to sound like Stewie. You,
off of Family Guy. You make me sick. You are so, oh my goodness. But yeah, we're close. We'll be there in like 11 minutes. So.
It didn't seem like 11 minutes yesterday when I came. I stopped there. Got me the same wrap yesterday.
Yeah, she was like, well, we was in there. She's like, didn't you make mine yesterday? The girl was like, yeah. I'm like, Keisha swears she remembers everybody from the first day. Y'all tell me if y'all do this. We'll go to a store or go to the hospital or go somewhere. She'll see the name tag. It could be Bob, Lorena, Robert, Jack, Eric. She'll be like, oh, yeah, Eric, I also needed this. Like, she knows him.
I call him by their name.
Yeah.
I do a connection.
She does that. Then she'll be like, all right, Eric, bye. Have a good day. We'll see you next time we come. I'm
and
like.
We always tip good, so.
And, y'all, we do.
I left a tip yesterday. Who leaves tips at what? At freaking Subway. But the only reason why I left a
you
tip.
You left a tip. I ain't leave no tip.
Because I pay with my card. And when you pay with your card,
oh,
now it
tip.
Pops up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And she would just stand there looking. I was the only person in Subway.
We were the only ones there today.
Business looked kind of slow. And I didn't want to hit the no. The zero. So I just
I would have hit the zero because I mean, yeah, I feel like Subway is kind of like a waitress, but not. They do make your food and you get it, but it's not. But like Bae said, when we go out to eat, we do tip
they
good.
They get hourly pay.
They never,
you know, kindness. Is
yeah, they do. They never when we
godliness, so.
When we go out to eat, we never tip under $5. Mind y'all, we never tip under $8. I ain't gonna tell y'all how much, but we tip good. And if you're real good, if we love our waiter or waitress, and it's good, we let it be known because it's just, I mean, they don't have to do that. It's a lot to be dealing with the people. Then I can understand who they deal with and getting everything. It's a lot.
What you think, babe?
All right, y'all, we done made it. Hey, baby.
Hey.
We
now we gotta walk.
We had to find us some parking.
I feel like y'all, I should have worn my sundress today. Instead of looking like a dog. Let me say that quietly just in case. Yep. This is the same place because I remember the boys crying like right there.
Because that's where we all went to the bathroom to change and stuff.
We was parked way up here at the time. It wasn't that packed though.
Bet you need to sit down. Nah, yesterday a bee landed on my arm, but I think it was one of them sweat bees because I was sweating.
Did you bring your pink thing?
Hell yeah, I brought my rag. I gotta walk around with a sweat rag, y'all.
Look at I gotta carry.
All that beautiful nature. All right, we got to cross. Packed out here, y'all. All right, you got it after them. You braver than I am, but I ain't doing it.
You I don't step know about over. All that. That's too long.
Go up and then just step over.
Hell no, I'm going back.
Just go right there. You can't jump down.
Hell no, I can't jump down.
Well, she wasn't brave, y'all. Like me. I ain't. It ain't even a jump. You just step over. But I'm not brave.
Oh,
yeah, I'm not doing it.
My legs ain't that long.
And it's just that, what y'all see, that's what it is in reality. See? She just stepped right over.
She got long legs.
Be careful because it is slippery.
Well, you should have went up first.
Well, I did that, so if you fall back, I'm behind you.
Come on, but I mean, you messed up my crop. Watch this, go.
Y'all, it's hot.
I feel good.
I want to go put my feet in the water, but I want to eat first. I'm starving.
Okay.
It is. It's beautiful. I really
about to eat.
Would like to walk across that thing to see, but I know it's slippery as hell.
You ain't on with that one, dog.
Well, she's talking about that up there.
She on her own. I ain't even going down there. It's peaceful out here, though. It's a lot of people.
Yeah.
We're going to eat our lunch, and then we're going to walk around a little bit. See what's all going on.
Let me go on in. Just a little bit, not too far.
Sitting here chilling, y'all. We don't move.
Yes.
Rocks.
Slippery as hell.
Got the water going up
our
ass.
Don't know how we gonna get up.
We on a slippery ass rock.
I'm gonna get up like a dog on my fours, and then if I got a scooter, I'm getting up.
It's relaxing though out here.
Somebody's water bottle, probably Keisha's. Yours is in the trash.
Y'all, so we just left the lake. It was very relaxing. No, we still at the Bullhole. We left the lake.
Oh yeah, the lake.
I ain't had one of these in years.
And then I got me the Mexican strawberry one. He said
it is good. Oh, we had a good time. Baby, you have a good time.
We had a great time. We coming back next week, and we actually gonna swim and get the tubes to get in. Bae says she gonna do it.
Hell yeah.
My ice cream, my chin must have got hungry. Look.
Mine is melting fast.
Mine is too quick. I might eat it.
It's hot out here. I'm sweating.
Mm-hmm.
Our shorts are wet. Time for a shower.
These are dirty.
Baby.
Oh, my bad. This stuff is good. I'm gonna get this again. It is strawberry.
Yeah.
Real good.
You just gotta be worthy. Yeah. But you don't gotta be perfect. Oh. You just gotta be worthy. Yeah. No.